Hi everyone, welcome to Career Guide. And in the previous video, we have discussed how you can register as a counselor on NCS portal and what are the eligibility criteria for counselors on NCS. Now, in this second video, we will be discussing counselor handbook and counselor manual, which are available on NCS portal only. Let me show you where they are available. You have to just simply type on Google ncs.gov.in. On the official website of NCS, you have to go to counselor. And here you can see the e-resources available. So I'll be discussing this counselor handbook. So when you will click this, this will get downloaded. And when you will click this detailed user manual, this will get downloaded. Now this is a 94 page guideline for counselor, and it is the latest updated manual. You can see here, it was released on 25th July 2020. So first I'll be discussing about counselor handbook, which is provided by NCS portal. So here there's a brief introduction. What is NCS? NCS is a platform which provides job matching, career counseling, job notifications, vocational guidance, information on skill development courses, because it is a skill provider platform also. It also provides internships and similar related opportunities. You can access this portal with this website. Here it is given. Now how your counselor can benefit and what are the procedures? Where counselor can work here and provide career counseling services to job seekers and can even use other portal to utilize these opportunities. So we will discuss in this video. Now this is the registration process which I have already discussed with you. How to register. Now this is second step is all about view, update profile and send approval request. That I have also discussed that you have to update your four tabs of your dashboard, which are these education completeness, experience completeness, schedule and document. After completing these four tabs, you have to send a request to NCS and you can send which is available as send approval button there. And I'll be showing you how it looks like, okay, in the detailed manual. And these are the qualification thing which we have discussed, that whatever the qualification documents required, like these are the which were mandatory documents to upload on NCS portal. These are post graduation degree or certificate graduation degree or certificate. So either if you are a post graduate, so obviously you will upload your post graduation degree as well as your graduation degree certificate. And if you're only a graduate, it's also fine. You can upload your graduation degree, but with an additional certificate in diploma certificate in guidance and counseling, that is mandatory, which I have also discussed. Fine. So these were available, these guidelines and eligibility criteria for counselors are available in this link. When you will click this link, you will be redirected to eligibility criteria of counselors. Fine. Now here we are. Here we can see. This is the manual. This is eligibility criteria. You can find that eligibility criteria which we have discussed earlier on page 6. Fine. Let us move back. Fine. So here, after getting successfully registered and also getting approval from NCS, and I have also discussed if you are rejected, so it means that your profile is incomplete. You might have not updated your complete profile in all the four tabs. Okay. And make sure you are uploading correct documents, because once you have uploaded all the documents in the document section, you can't edit them, because they are considered as final for verification, as it has been mentioned in this note also. They are considered as final for verification and approval purpose, even if the user updates its details later. So you have to update your documents very carefully. Now, once your profile is sent for approval, now your profile status will be showing as pending for approval. Once you have sent the approval button, applied the request. Okay, now these are the process. Either approve the, now DG admin may approve your profile, reject the profile, or ask for more information. If they aren't satisfied with your profile or with all your documents, they can ask for more information, because it might happen that you haven't uploaded mandatory documents on your profile. Fine. So you have to abide to all the terms and conditions which are asked by NCS. Now the third step is add services and manage schedule. Now this is very important. Now after creating a proper profile, and also if you have also been approved by NCS, now what else you can do after that? So counselor can specify the type of counseling services that he can render by choosing from the list of services given under My Services tab. Okay, we will look this later. So My Services tab, in the left navigation panel of the counselor dashboard, here in this area you will be getting to know this My Services tab will be there. You can access that, and you can also search other counseling services there and which services for you are suitable. Counselor user can schedule counseling sessions as per his availability by using add new schedule. You can also add new schedules in schedule tab under schedule tab of the counselor dashboard, and you can also delete or edit those schedules by clicking your action button. Now the fourth step is view appointments. Okay, now if you have any appointments or pending approvals, so counselor can also view those and edit, approve or reject received appointment request under view pending approvals tab. So this will also be available on your dashboard, view a pending approval tabs. By just, you can access this by clicking on the action button. You can edit those approvals as well. And you can also look out for your view appointments tab by marking leaves on particular dates using leave plan tab, which will automatically cancel any of the book appointments during the specified leave period, and job seeker will get notified about the same. So you can also apply for leave. If you are not able to work for some time, you can apply leave under leave plan tab. Fine. Now the next step is search and apply jobs. So like any other job seeker, you can also apply for and search for jobs by clicking on search jobs tab available on your counselor dashboard. And job search can be customized by using specific keywords. How you can use that? Like, you can also filter your search by applying location, expected salary, or using advanced search parameters. So after setting the search criteria, click the search button. Like after just applying all the filters, you have to click on search for searching all other jobs available. So all the jobs will be available on your screen then. And a counselor user can also save job search criteria to get job notification emails on registered email ID. So means you will stay updated when you will click on this save job search, and when you will click get job notifications, and when you will also verify your email ID with NCS portal, then you will be getting updated notifications for your job search. Now, what are the job fairs? Now here also job fairs and events are also being held. They are conducted on periodic basis where employers and job seekers come together for the purpose of recruitment. Counselor user can view, register and participate for the upcoming job fairs and events by selecting the job fairs and events tab. This is another tab which is available on the counselor dashboard only. Fine. Now this is a user manual, which is detailed user manual for the counselor. Now after clicking this, we'll be redirected to the detailed manual. Okay. Now this is also available on the NCS portal only. Now this is a 94-page guideline. But what is important for you? Let me skim through this all document and tell you the important information only. So this is all getting started. We have already discussed that how you have to register as a counselor. Let me zoom this. Yes. So we have also discussed this registration form for a counselor. After that, the registration process. Now this is the thing which you'll be appearing when you will be verifying your mobile number or email ID via OTP. Now this is reset password notification. Reset password notification is something like if you forget your password, so you can reset your password. There is a forward password option available also. So this is all about that. Yes, so this is how a counselor dashboard looks like. Let me show you. Yeah, so this is, you can see these are the tabs. These are the all the tabs which were also labeled on the NCS official homepage, which these are. And you can see here at the left navigation tab, view update, NCS profile, view profile, my services. You can hear, this is the schedule tab. You can schedule your appointments and all the tasks. Here you can apply for leave under leave plan tab. Appointments, if you have any appointments, if you have any approvals pending, you can here apply for search jobs. And you can also, and this tab will show you how many jobs you have applied for. These are the job recommendations. Okay, when you have saved your filtered job search here in this tab, then you can get recommendations here. Feedback on local services, here you can apply for job fair or event which is being held online. Now this is your four tab profile status which I was discussing in the previous videos also. Like this is education completeness, experience completeness, schedule completeness, and here now the status has been approved. This is showing that this status has been approved. You have completed all your three options. And I think here the fourth tab is being missed here. That is document completeness also. I think here that has been missed. And here it is, reports and documents. And this is the manual again, which we are already discussing. This is the detailed user manual, which I have already opened. And we have already discussed about handbook and flowchart. Okay. And this is how it looks like in the current week, what else you have scheduled and what else you the work you're pending work, it is displaying like this. So it's a very organized platform, very easy to handle. Now this is a profile status. I have discussed already that you have, for completing your profile status and getting approval by NCS, you have to complete four tabs, education completeness, so at least one. This means like education completeness greater than completed when at least one education qualification is entered, right? Then only education detail tab will get completed. Then at least one experience, at least one schedule you have created, and then at least one document you have uploaded. And how you will upload your documents? On your DigiLocker account. Okay, how a DigiLocker account works, let us see. Okay, so NCS portal also provide DigiLocker. I have also told you that NCS and DigiLocker are interrelated to each other. They're interconnected actually, because NCS portal is now integrated with DigiLocker services, and which allows you to upload and download your documents. So if you are already a registered NCS portal, you can also register and sign up for DigiLocker account. And then you can create another DigiLocker account for yourself and upload your documents, and can keep your documents safe and can access anywhere. Okay, so this was all about DigiLocker account. Let us move back. I think the user manual, this is user manual which we were discussing. Okay. Next up we have, you can see here, all four tabs. Now if your profile isn't completed, then it will show you like, let me zoom in, then it will show you like incomplete profile, because these four tabs are incomplete. And this is how your document completeness tab will look like. This is your DigiLocker Connect. By clicking on this, you will be redirected to a page where you have to complete your registration as a DigiLocker counselor account. Okay, and this is the option available if you have to upload any additional experience certificate of yourself. Fine. Now the next step, we have profile status. Okay, now after clicking on this, you can see additional experience certificates. Now this will be appearing as like this. You can see you can upload here. There are four options available for additional certificates. Now this is how your incomplete profile status looks like. And this is how when you have completed all your four tabs and you have sent your request to NCS. Now this is a button you have to proceed further. So when you will click on this send approval button, then this dialog box will appear. If you are a VJ expert, please ensure that you have uploaded diploma certificate in guidance counseling. Now, if you are a VJ expert, then only this is mandatory for uploading. Okay. So then you have to click on OK, proceed. Now, as you have clicked on this button, send for approval, then it will be showing you like pending for approval. Now, once your profile gets approved by NCS, it will show status as approved. Next up, we have view update counselor profile. Now, if you even want to update after getting successfully registered on NCS portal, if you want to update your profile in terms of documents or experience, you can also do that. Like you can, after clicking on experience tab, this is how your experience tab looks like. Showing you as a work experience in terms of key skills, total experience, available to join in days, current class salary and salary duration type, current employment organization time, and currently seeking for a job. If you are seeking for a job, you have to make sure tick to this. And this is your employment history will look like. And if you even more want to add more employment history, you have to click on this button, add more. And these are the preferences for your job search, like in which location you are searching and what is the type of job nature you are looking for, and shift timings which are suitable for you. And then you have to save. Now, when you save this, your preferred job search, you can go to the job recommendations to look for further recommendations. And you can also even link your email ID to the NCS portal to get notifications on your email ID. Now this is the tab, how your education and training details tab looks like. This is the screen. Okay, now it is showing the training details, history, qualifications, training courses. If you have done any, you can add here. You can update your profile, assessment report. This is your assessment report. If you have completed any assessment report here, and then you have to click on save for updating your profile. This is how your add education pop-up dialog box appears. Okay, so these are the details which you have to fill. Now here there's a note. You can mention multiple records of education history and information regarding additional qualifications. You can also upload the digital copies of those very records with corresponding mark sheet. So always you have to upload your mark sheet or any important document on DigiLocker account only. Okay, so by clicking on add more button, you can add more qualification, training or courses if you have done any later on. Fine. Next up, we have personal information tab. This is how your personal information looks like. Okay, you can even upload your CV here. Let me zoom it for you. You can also upload caste certificate. So make sure when you are filling any OBC category, category as OBC, then only this option gets open. Okay, but if you're filling general category, then obviously you can't upload as a caste certificate here because there's no caste certificate available for general, right? Now, this is your unique identification document thing. You can even add more, like if you want to add your PAN card detail also. And this, and here you can access your Aadhaar card by clicking on DigiLocker Connect. These are the physical attributes, okay? You can even upload your, like if you are differently abled, then you can even upload this certificate here. This is the miscellaneous section, how it looks like. Okay, this is the employment status. Are you a government services retired? So, or are you an ex-serviceman? You can here fill your information. After that, you can upload your CV as well. Okay, we have covered this. Now, this is unique identification thing. If you have to update your unique identification type, you can click on that update button and again type here the information. Notice the certificate number, certificate issued by, and certificate issued date and upload differently abled certificate fields are activated if you only select the yes option. Obviously, when you will click that you are differently abled, then only it will get activated. Then we have communication tabs, how it looks like. It is all about your current address, permanent address. Fine. Now the next tab is my reference tab. If you want to upload your references, you can upload here. Okay. Now this is your logout of the application. Now if you want to log out, you have to just click here and this drop down list, and this option will appear, sign out, then you will be logged out from this NCS portal. Okay, now this is my services, how you can use my services tab on the top. My services screen looks like this. This is career counseling, or like if you want to update your profile as that you are also providing career counseling and you're also a vocational guidance expert, then you can update here in my services tab. If you want to schedule anything, you can click on your schedule tab and add schedules, and it looks like this. You can see here schedule title, location, from. Okay, it also mentioned date, timing, seats, fees, days. Okay, so how this is how your schedule screen looks like. Next up we have, if you want to add more schedules, how you will be adding by clicking add more option here. By clicking add new schedule, you can add more schedules also. Okay, so this is how you add your information here. Okay, and you can even add your location. Then we have edit existing schedule. Okay, if you want to edit your existing schedule, you can also do that by clicking on action drop down button. So this is how your edit schedule pop-up appears. Okay, you can change the date here and then you can click on save changes button. Leave plan, if you want to mark any leave, then you have to click on this leave plan tab. Then you can mark your leave here and you can save your things. Then we have view appointments. So this is how your view appointment screen appears. You can see here. Here dates are available. And this is how your appointments, if there's any, you can look for here. Look for them. And then we have appointment search results. This appears like this, like if you have any appointment pending, like here's the candidate name and contact number. Then we have view appointments. Again, this is the same thing. Now if you want to cancel any appointment, You have to just click on action and then click cancel. Reason for cancellation, you have to then submit. Now in the view pending approvals, you can see this is how your screen appears. Okay, whatever the pending approvals you have, you can always edit and you can approve and reject your approvals by clicking on this action drop down button. Fine. Next up we have, this is how your approval rejection reason dialog box appear. And then you have to click on submit button. Now if you want to search for jobs, how you can do that? By clicking here, search for jobs. You can apply for keywords like for which kind of job you are looking for, like even if you are looking for a career counselor or if you account, sales, data entry, then you can add your preferred location or Pan India and then expected salary, organization time, and then you can here save your criteria and also search lively. Fine. Next up we have, you can see this is how job search portal appears. Advanced search options are there. Like you can even also mention sector, functional area, functional role, work experience, job nature, age, shift timings, gender, category, okay, disability type, okay. So these are the all additional options. So this is how a job appears on NCS portal. So till now we have covered a lot of many options. Fine. This is the disclaimer, how it looks like. Vacancies by category, you can even find your jobs in terms of vacancies which are available on home page only. Find job vacancies by section. These are the job categories. Like if you are looking your jobs in terms of location, these are job subcategories. And this is search job screen, how it looks like, we have already discussed. This is how a disclaimer pop-up looks like. Based on your current profile, you do not match the, like this is your disclaimer. Okay, like it will also show you like if you are suitable or not for this particular job. This is job description page. You can see here. And next up we have job details. So when you are clicking any job and you, if you like that job, then you can also go to look out all the job details, job description, and what are the required criteria for that. Then we have another information. Next thing, I think we have mostly covered all the sections. These are the jobs by partners. Okay, if you are applying in by NCS partners, job posting by NCS partner, you can also filter your research by this. Jobs applied, in jobs applied section, you can see this is how your job applied screen appears. Job recommendations, in this tab, you can get all the recommendations according to your saved job preferences. This is the job recommendation tab again. Now this is how our recommendation is looking on the screen. Feedback on local services. This is how your feedback on local services look like. Okay, you can request and search accordingly. So when you request, this is how feedback pop-up appears. Okay. Then we have feedback form. Okay, so this is all about how you can fill your feedback form. Now, job fair and events. So this is how a job fair event screen looks like. These are the events like which may be happening, and you can also go for upcoming event search, ongoing and past by filtering the search. You can also filter your search by giving information of state, district and industry you are looking for. Okay, these are the again additional filters. Search for job fairs. Okay, so how you can click on search button after applying all the filters, you can click on search button. So this is how you you can look for job fairs in this job fairs tab and events in this events tab. Okay, and if you want to search a particular job, if you are interested in this, you can here click here for details, for knowing more details for that. So this is how job fair details look like. And this is how you can see your calendar, job fair result calendar. Like if you're interested, if you have apply, like if you're interested or if you're going to that job fair event, so then it looks like this. Then we have job fair details. This we have already discussed. Job fair participation. Okay, this is all about how you can participate in the job fairs and events. So you will be getting familiar, and we have mostly discussed all the important things. You will be getting familiar once you get registered and once you are using all the tabs on a regular basis. So this is all about your pre-registration screen appears when you are registering for any event. You have to give your personal information. Okay, so I hope that this will help you a lot. Thank you so much. Let me close this.